FORT-2 is a was a phase 1b/2 study looking at atezolizumab and rogaratinib. Atezolizumab is a PD-L1 inhibitor. Rogaratinib is an FGFR inhibitor. And the study design was somewhat unique in that rather than selecting patients based on the mutation status, it was conducted based on overexpression of FGFR3 as an entry criteria, as determined by mRNA expression using a technique called RNA scope. And so patients who entered the study had overexpression of FGFR3 or I believe two as well, but mostly FGFR3. And these patients all received atezolizumab and rogaratinib initially at a dose escalation, which identified 600 milligrams of rogaratinib twice a day as the recommended phase 2 dose with atezolizumab, and then a phase 2 cohort. And the response rate, an expansion cohort, and the response rate was 58%, which in a PD-L1 low FGFR3 positive cohort seems better than we might expect. Again, a small trial with all the caveats that go with that, not randomized, but certainly compares favorably to historical data with atezolizumab alone in that setting where you might expect the responses in the 20s. We don't have solid data on rogaratinib by itself in that setting, but my expectation is it's probably not got a response rate of 58% on its own, based on other data with rogaratinib that was seen in the past. And so where rogaratinib is going in bladder cancer development is unclear, but hopefully this will get picked up into a larger study to allow us to further explore whether this is in fact a viable pathway forward. We do see, you know, typical toxicities of both drugs, with rogaratinib causing, skin toxicity and hyperphosphatemia, and some gastrointestinal toxicity. And there are the expected immune-related adverse events with atezolizumab, but none of them seem to be exacerbated particularly. The correlative sciences were also interesting in that you saw responses in patients that were FGFR3 overexpressed, but not mutated or without fusions either. So these are FGFR3 wild type, as far as we can tell. And those patients, there were patients who responded. There were patients who responded to FGFR3 mutation in addition to overexpression. And there were less responses in patients who had PI3 kinase mutations, which you might expect because that's upstream of FGFR3 and in parallel pathways and might be associated with resistance to rogaratinib and FGFR3 inhibitor therapy. And so it provides an additional potential mechanism for patient selection in the future trials. Perhaps patients with PI3 kinase mutations may not be best served by going on this trial. And it might be a better op. It might be a good way to select patients in the future would be PI3 kinase wild type, FGFR3 overexpressed in this for future development of this combination.